We want to determine the equation for the exponential function from the graph using a form of f of x equals a times b raised to the power of x. But this one's a little bit more involved than the other examples because notice how this graph does have a horizontal asymptote of y equals positive 4, which means the exponential function would have to be shifted up 4 units in order to have this horizontal asymptote. This graph also appears to be exponential decay that's been reflected across the x-axis. So we should recognize that the value of a is going to be negative, but if nothing else, we do have to recognize that the exponential function has been shifted up 4 units because of this horizontal asymptote, which means our exponential function will be in the form of f of x equals a times b raised to the power of x plus 4. So once we recognize this, then we can determine the values of a and b by identifying two points on the function that will give us two function values. So notice how this point here, or the y-intercept, is 0, 2, and this point here is the point negative 1, negative 4, which means if the function contains the point 0, 2, f of 0 must equal 2, and if the function contains the point negative 1, negative 4, then f of negative 1 must equal negative 4. Now that we know f of 0 equals 2, we should be able to use this to determine the value of a, and then we can use the second function value to determine the value of b. So if f of 0 equals 2, we'll replace x with 0, so we would have a times b to the 0 plus 4 must equal positive 2. Well, b to the 0 is equal to 1, so we have a plus 4 equals 2. Subtract 4 on both sides. So we have a equals negative 2. So now we know that f of x must equal negative 2 times b to the power of x plus 4. Notice how a is negative, which is what we thought, because it does look like this is exponential decay reflected across the x-axis. So now we'll use this form of our function and our second function value to determine the value of b. And let's go ahead and do that on the next slide. So we were able to use f of 0 equals 2 to determine the value of a, and now we'll use f of negative 1 equals negative 4 to determine the value of b. So f of negative 1 is going to be equal to negative 2 times b to the negative 1 plus 4, which must equal negative 4. So for the first step, let's go ahead and subtract 4 on both sides. So we have negative 2 b to the negative 1 equals negative 8. Now I'm going to make this into a fraction. And remember, if I move the b down to the denominator, it's going to change the sign of the exponent. So we would have negative 2 over b equals negative 8. And now we're going to multiply both sides of the equation by b. This is b over 1, so the b simplify out. We have negative 2 equals negative 8b. Now we can divide both sides by negative 8. So we have b equals, this simplifies to positive 1/4. So now that we have b, we have our function. Our function is f of x equals negative 2 times the base of 1/4 raised to the power of x plus 4. Now hopefully we recognize that because the base is between 0 and 1, we have exponential decay. Because a is negative, it's reflected across the x-axis. Because of the 2, it's been vertically stretched. And because of the plus 4, it's been shifted up 4 units. And these transformations do describe the provided graph in red. I hope you found this helpful.